famous movie presentation that he does on Izhak Bear. Some of you might from Boston might know about it. A word about the speaker. We're going to be addressed by the Rosh Hashiva, who is the founder and dean of Ish Torah here in Jerusalem. The Ish Torah is the College of Jewish Studies, and also the international organization knows the Ish Torah. The branches are its feet and material as well. Rav Noach Weinberg got his degree in Loyola University, and he got his rabbinical ordination in Baltimore, and he lives here with his family, and we're very, very privileged to have him speak to us. We have five level selections.
Thank you. Okay, look, you know, we get youngsters from the United States, from university, yeah? If we ask them, you believe in God, they will say no. There's a brainwashing going on here, yeah? 80% will say outright, we're atheists. The other 20%, one out of five, will say, well, maybe some kind of force and we'll not put none. And it's prayer. Yeah. Nonsense. So we don't do that. We won't ask you that. But what do? We ask them, tell me, did you ever pray? One time in your life, did you ever pray? You had a test coming. You're trying to move too fast. There's a sight of you. The other guy, yeah? Did you ever pray? Everybody prayed. Raise the hand. Did you ever feel that God answered your prayer? Raise your hand. Go on, let's see how many. Yeah? You take a look. You should ask God. Tell me. You got it? So, you said God answered your prayer? Yes? You said God answered your prayer? You said God? You say it out, right? You said God answered your prayer? What pains? How you can cooperate? You laugh at you. You're primitive. You don't pay God. Yeah? Do you guys know that when we came into the world that we're paying God with the firstborn? With a fat cow? Remember when you heard something about history? Yeah? We taught the world. He created everything. Time, space, energy, matter. What are you going to pay? So they might be atheists, but they know you don't pay God. We taught them, yeah? He said, you didn't pay him anything? No, nothing. Why in the world did he listen to you? Who the heck are you? There's 6 billion people on the planet. Hello, hello. Even with call identification, he knows it's you. Why pick it up? Picks it up, listens to you. And he takes care of what you want. That's good service, huh? To try to get that from your stewards. Right? Till you get their attention. Right? So, why in the world did he listen to you? Does that mean that he loves you? Hmm? Yeah? You don't know that. It's God created this universe as a person. Hey man, it's fine, but I don't know where to go. He loves us. So what the heck does he want from us? What does he want from us? What's all the commandments? A religion has something to do with serve God. Yeah, how do you serve God? We Jews, we taught the world there's nothing you can give up, yeah? So how do you serve God? Come on, what do you say? You got some ideas? Yeah, so that somebody's listening to me around here, huh? How do you serve God? Hello? He loves us. How do we serve Him?
By executing this command of God, his will, and his Torah.
Yeah, why? What are you doing for Him? Yeah?
Take care of what He created.
He can't do it. He needs us.
Yeah.
Come on. He created it. What can we do for God?
Mitzvahs.
Mitzvahs. Why?
Because it's good for us.
See, we use the expression, our Father in heaven. What can you do for your parents? What can you do for your parents?
Respect them?
Yeah, they need a little respect. God doesn't need respect. What can you do for your parents? When you have children, why are you going to have children? You're going to have children one day, Mirz Hashem, yeah? What are you going to do for them? You think you're going to get breakfast in bed? Very expensive breakfast. You can do better with an English butler, better service, much cheaper. Right? So why have children? What do you want from your children, young lady? You're going to have children? What do you want from them? You know what, you kids, you got to wake up. You're going to give your children ice cream and candy and toys and go, kuchi, 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 yeah. Their pleasure is your pleasure. Do you get that? The Almighty Creator of this universe, He created us for one purpose. Our pleasure. Hello? You get that? Then what the heck's wrong? You want pleasure? We do. We're all pleasure seekers. 6 billion people in this world, they get up in the morning until they go to sleep at night and they pick it up the next morning. You know what they're looking for? Pleasure. You got out of bed this morning, you made a decision. You think it's more probable that you get pleasure out of bed than in bed. Otherwise, you'd still be hugging the pillow. Is that a fact?
Yes.
We're doomed to seek pleasure. We're pleasure seekers. Then what's wrong? Heck of a lot of misery out there. Yeah? You notice? Now, the Almighty, He knows what He's doing. He created this beautiful world for our pleasure. Yeah? What is wrong?
Immorality.
You know what's wrong? What?
Immorality.
But you want pleasure, everybody wants pleasure. Yeah? So in Judaism we say people make mistakes. They're all reaching for pleasure and they come up with a can of worms. You get it? It's mistakes. We don't have a word sin. The word that's translated chet al chet, the generic term, is mistake. Nachtiyata matara means you miss your target. Everybody wants pleasure. Everybody wants pleasure. Everybody. Let me cue you in a little bit. You're getting married one day, yeah? Mitz Hashem, right? 50% get a divorce. You're going to get a divorce? Not me. Why not? I don't plan to. Yeah? So let me give you a little tip. Yeah? You can ask any married man. Or choose any married man. This guy's married. You're married?
I'm married.
Ask him. When your wife is miserable, are you miserable? What do you think they're going to say? For sure. So why you make your wife miserable? Hello?
What if your wife makes herself miserable?
And
what if she gets...
Oh, that's another problem. You don't have to add to it. Yeah, right? But I have to teach her a lesson. I can't let her get away with it. Did it ever help? Did it ever help? We make mistakes. We got to teach her a lesson. We got to, yeah? You young ladies, you know? You can ask any married woman. When your husband is miserable, are you miserable? Huh? And boy, can they make us miserable. They know how. Alright? Yeah? So enjoy yourself. That's a good prescription, a good idea for a happy marriage. Make each other miserable. Is that right? Okay, the biggest mistake we can make is we don't know what our pleasure is. So let's say you guys became real religious on the spot and you want to serve God, right? Real. You want to serve God. So you're going to go and get pleasure. That's your obligation. Yeah? What are you going to do? Hello? What are you going to do? Hello? What are you going to do?
Learn.
What?
Learn.
If you're smart, you'll learn what your pleasure is. Now we have a set of instructions that we repeat every morning and every night what our pleasure is about. And I'm going to share that set of instructions with you. Yeah? And the set of instructions says that there's five classes of pleasure. You know what classes are? You came with an international flight. An international flight, if you look, they have a counter first class. Yeah? You ever notice? What do they call it? First class. Yeah? Anybody goes over there, yeah, first class. Yeah. You like to go first class? Everybody likes to go first class. Yeah. They call it first class. Then they have second class. You ever notice? Second class. Did you ever see a design second class? Never second class. Business. Executive. Yeah? Never, you'll never see a sign second class. That's what it is. Yeah? Shh. It's business. It's executive. You get it? We want to go first class, not second. Get it? Then they have a sign third class. Did you ever see a sign third class? Never. What do they call it?
Economy,
tourist, cabin, whatever you like. They'll never call it third class. We human beings are born to go first class. Okay, we'll settle for business. All right, I'll be a tourist. Yeah. We want to go first class. You get that? Yeah? We're little children of the Almighty. We deserve first class. Yeah? If they had fourth class, yeah, can stick it into the luggage compartment. You get it? That's fourth class. Fifth class, they give you a rope, tie it to the tail of the plane, off you go. If you hang on long enough, you get to Israel too. But boy, is it a hassle. You kids, you are striving to get along on fifth class pleasure. Enjoy yourself. It's a hassle, but little moments of, yeah, we made a couple of miles back, we're hanging on, yeah. Fifth class. What's fifth class pleasure? What do you think is pleasure? If you ask an American, what is pleasure? What's pleasure? Yeah, well, usually they talk about the counterfeit, but if you talk to them about pleasure, snorkeling, music, beautiful home, a nice car, first-class restaurant, a steak, golf, tennis. Ah, that's living, yeah? Yeah, it's living, fifth class. Skiing, fifth class, yeah? It's good. Fifth class. It's not enough, yeah? Now, even for fifth-class pleasure, you gotta learn how to enjoy it. Yeah, you like golf. Yeah, how long did it take you to get a swing? Yeah? All right, but you work at it. Yeah? Yeah, you still don't have it. All right. But you want to play tennis. You want to? Yeah, it takes an effort. You ever take a course in art appreciation? How many of you are art appreciation? Nobody. No, they don't sell it anymore. How about music appreciation?
I'm a music major, so.
Yeah. Music major. Okay, so they give you a course, yeah? If you have a good professor who really loves music and is able to articulate and show you how to listen, music is different the rest of your life. I don't know if you people know, in the better universities, they give you a course in wine tasting. They give you a course in wine tasting. Now, if you have a good drunk, lush, a professor who really loves wine, yeah, and he knows how to articulate it, yeah, he teaches him how to look for the body, the legs. I don't take it. You got it? So really, you should learn how to enjoy even fifth class pleasure. Yeah. Even fifth class pleasure, you're not getting your money's worth. Yeah. Okay, it's fifth class. What's fourth class pleasure? No exchange rate, no amount of fifth class pleasure is equal to the unit, one unit of fourth class pleasure. You get that? Hello, do you hear that? Do you want pleasure? Yeah? I'm telling you, all the pleasures of fourth class to a billionaires is not equal to one unit of fourth class pleasure. You believe me? Yeah,
very good. Yes,
you believe me? So what's fifth class pleasure? The greatest pleasure most human beings will ever have. Greatest pleasure most human beings will ever consciously have. What? Children. You get that? What's your parents' greatest pleasure?
Children.
You get that? Children. Is that right? Isn't that right? Tell me, what's your parents' greatest pain?
Us.
What?
Us. Us.
Hey, you kids, you think you're going to have children without pain? Isn't that right? You've got to find out how to deal with it, yeah? If you're afraid of pain, forget it. You got it? Okay, so let me ask you. If I was going to come to your father, yeah, and offer him $20 million, yeah? $20 million. What's your name?
Dima.
I'd say $20 million. You know, you come in with a Brinks truck and $20 million. Did you ever see $20 million in cash?
No.
No, but you know that if you saw $20 million in cash, yeah?
In cash.
And you put it on the table, he says, What for? What's this? For Dima. Nothing's going to happen. You'll move to Israel. You'll go to a kibbutz. You won't know whether you ever got married, whether you had children, how's he doing, what's it. You won't know anything about it. Yeah? Would you take it?
Probably.
You
take a lot less.
My hope is. Right? Okay, so you take away the $20 million, right? You know what her father's going to do the rest of the week? What's he going to do the rest of the week?
Progress.
Huh?
Buy lots of cigars.
You know what he's going to do the rest of the week? He's going to follow, what's your name?
Leslie.
Leslie. He's going to follow Leslie around the whole day, looking at her. Is that a fact or not? Huh?
Yeah.
You understand? You're not going to get your money from this. You're going to spend money on your kids. You're going to be aggravated one day, sick. You're going to take you all this. You're not going to get your money's worth unless you know how to enjoy love. You need a course in love tasting. Hello? Register or not? Where do you get a course in like that? That's a fact. The Jewish people. We taught the world, love your neighbor as yourself. You know what comes from Judaism? Yeah? So you ask, should you love nice neighbors? Is it the right thing to do? Is it a good thing to do?
Yeah.
Can I obligate you to love someone?
No.
No. It's the right thing to do. Are you obligated to do the right thing?
No.
It's a good thing to do. You're not obligated to do the right thing. It's what we should do. Is it obligation to do what you should do? What the heck is an obligation to you people? In Judaism, we say it's an obligation. Can you define love? Hello, if you want to do something, you've got to have a definition. Do you understand that? Can you define love? Come on, you guys. Can you define love? No? 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 That's a miracle. Can you define love? What?
Pleasure.
You were tipped off. Yeah. Out there, they don't know what the definition of love is. I ask you,
You love your father?
Yes.
Yeah. You love your mom?
Yep.
You love the cop who gave you a ticket?
No.
No. You love the mechanic who ripped you off?
Yes, no, I don't love him.
You don't love him? Do you buy full stick your father?
Yeah, what?
Buy full stick. What's that? I didn't ask you what it is. I asked you, do you or don't you? How can I tell you? I don't know what you're talking about. But you answered about what? So you have an issue, yeah? That's right, you just lazy in the head. Yeah? Come into the yeshiva, we'll give you the definition, you can check it out. But to walk around the rest of your life, you don't know. When you get married, you want the guy to love you or are you infatuated? Which one? Love, yeah, right? Yeah? Who said that? Lisa? Who said it? Okay, so you can ask him, do you love me? What's he going to say? No, I'm infatuated. Yes. How are you going to know? Did you get that? See, you got to learn what the heck love is about. Unfortunately, you got to go to a yeshiva. They don't teach it in university. That's too nonsense. They don't teach you how to stay married. That's too nonsense. In Judaism, we say love. Love yourself, love humanity. I'm going to teach you how. But it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. What's third class pleasure? That's fourth class pleasure. Third class pleasure, no exchange rate. No exchange rate. No exchange rate. Yeah, what's third class pleasure?
Creating something.
What?
Creating something.
That's second class. What's third class? Third class pleasure. So what will you give up? A wonderful home, billions of dollars, a wife that you love, children, you give it all up. To get what?
Leader of a nation.
What?
Leader of a nation.
Leader of a nation? Leader of a nation. That's power. But short of that.
Better
wife and
better kids.
Better wife. Wow. Wow. Okay, what? Every one of you, you've got to know yourself. Yeah, what? Do you want to say something? No. Every one of you is ready to give up a wonderful husband, wonderful children, a beautiful mansion, being a leader of the nation, the whole world. For what?
No.
So let me show you. You've got to know yourself. Let me show you. What do you say, young man? Would you kill 1,000 innocent children, hostages? They're not throwing stones, nothing, to save your life. Either you kill them or they'll kill you.
No, I wouldn't kill them.
You wouldn't? Why not?
They're innocent, they didn't do it.
It's wrong, right? Your wife and your children say, come on, please, we need you. Come on, kill me. If you wanted to, you try. One guy, yeah. You say, kill me. Is that a fact? Huh?
I don't know.
You don't know. What do you say? You had a knife and you killed your kid. What do you say? Tell me, if you drive a car and you kill a kid by accident, how do you feel? Huh? You'd be devastated. Say, you're going to take a knife and kill a kid. You don't know yourself. If you know that you're willing to die rather than kill 1,000 kids, that means that you're willing to die to be good. Got that? You're willing to die to be good. If you're willing to die to be good, then live for it. If you're willing to live for it, you're a darn fool if you don't learn how to enjoy it. It must be very, very heavy stuff. You got it? Now the fact is, you're going to live for it whether you like it or not.
Okay, so you're saying that you would give up
your wife and your kids to be good?
That's the fact.
That's the point. Yeah.
When it dawns on you what good is, as far as you're concerned, you don't know what good is. So you say, that's what I gotta do, but to kill me, I can't do it. We have inborn in us what's good. Would you slap a fellow in the face? I'll give you $100. No consequences.
Done. Pick a fellow in the face.
How about you?
Take it to a dog.
Slap a guy for $100? I'll split the money with them, and that'll be that. Yeah, like.
I say just drop $100.
How about you?
What you doing?
How about you?
See?
$100. Slap him hard. Shake him off.
No. I don't know. Probably not.
How about $1,000?
Yeah.
You said there's no consequences?
No consequences.
If there's no consequences, then maybe.
How about you?
You mean beat him up?
For $1,000.
You can try.
How about you? How about you? Would do. How about $10,000?
That's
how much. Usually by $10,000, the guy says, split it with him. Can't split it with him. How about $1,000,000? Yes, sir. Well, what's the matter? Is that okay to kill him and smack him for $1,000,000? I've done worse for less.
Would you do it for $1,000,000?
No.
You would not slap a man for $1,000,000.
Not slap a man for $1,000,000. On Shabbos for $1,000,000. And I won't eat one piece of pork for $1,000,000. You got it?
Wait, hold on. So, would you need support
if it's not, your wife and child are going to die?
My mind says to avoid the death of another person, you eat pork and you light a fire on Shabbos. Otherwise, you don't do it. If God says don't, are you smarter? Yeah? Well, I will need a piece of pork for $100,000,000. You're not talking, man.
What if God told you to do this once?
Pardon me?
What if God told you to do this once?
God told me to shoot you, I shoot.
Good.
God told me to do it, I do it. Yeah? Okay. So look, my children, you don't understand, but you're doomed to be good. Without self-respect, young man, you will wither away. You have to say, I am a good person, even if you're a murderer. I have to defend myself. I have to fight society. Do you understand that? We need self-respect or we can't move. But we just think ourselves good. Yeah? You get that? You see, in each category there is the counterfeit. In each category there is the counterfeit. Counterfeit fifth highest pleasure is lust. It's not pleasure, it's lust. Did you ever disappear in a bag of potato chips? Yes, you know what I mean? You take one, it's delicious. Another, it's delicious. You hit the bottom of the bag, it turned from being delicious into chewing. You thought you were chewing it. You were. You turned off your head. You were suffering. But you had this confusion. Yeah. You think the guy's on heroin? Enjoying it? That drunk's enjoying it? They're just confused. Do you get that? That's lust. That's the physical sensation. Yeah? Okay, what's the counterfeit love? Counterfeit. You can swear it's love. It's not.
Oh, I'm infatuation.
Infatuation. Infatuation. It's not love. Yeah? You know how you tell the difference? You want a tip on how to tell the difference? You want to love the guy before you say yes, right? You know how to tell the difference? How?
Is it true?
Did you ever hear the love is blind? Yeah? That's a lie. You get that? It's a lie. How do you know it's a lie? Who loves you most in this world?
My parents.
Who sees you faults better than anybody else?
My parents.
You love someone, you see his faults. With a magnifying glass. Yeah? If your friend, if your neighbor's kid is depressed, you say, they really, they should do something about it. God forbid you have a depressed kid, you're tearing your hair out. Get me up, what can I do? You get it? You see that? So I tell a hint, and he said, you know, don't, if somebody proposes to you, yeah, ask him, tell me five faults that you've seen me. If he says, no, you're perfect, my dear, run for your life. He's blind. Yeah? I mean, you know you're not perfect. I haven't insulted you, right? You got it? I tell the guys, never propose unless you find five faults. You get that, Dima? Five faults before you revoke. Then you tear it up. You're married. Okay, so counterfeit love is infatuation. What's counterfeit good that you're all gonna bust your chops to get? You're doomed to knock yourself out to get what? The counterfeit of good. What's the counterfeit of good? Come on. Huh? Success. Success. If you're not successful with all the balance you got, you're gonna be is that right? Not success. Huh? What do you say? It's gonna be hell. What do you say, Dina? Is it gonna be hell if you're not successful?
What?
If you're not successful. Huh?
I can't hear what you're saying.
If you're not successful,
success means that you're good. If you're not successful, you're good.
What's the definition of success?
What?
What's the definition of success?
Success is you throw that ball and it gets there, right? And you throw a ball and it goes back. You go, yeah? Success is that whatever you take, you are your CEO. The good job in teaching.
That's just one kind of success. What about like success in like
your
family?
Well, people have different orientation to success. Yeah. A junk is it's got to have a good
body, right?
A professor has got to be an intellectual. Right? A lawyer has got to have a practice. An artist, he's got to sell a painting, you know, right? It's going to where you're going, but what's really good meaning? Yeah? Okay, but you got to learn how to enjoy it. So can I give you just an indication of how to enjoy being good? That really we're desperate to the pleasure of being good. It's a desperate desire that we have, yeah? So, you guys know about the circle line of Manhattan? Anybody visit Manhattan? Yeah? Yeah? You know the circle line? Beautiful. Yeah? They are on the circle line, yeah? The guy's leaning too far forward. Falls in. Yeah? There's no life preserver, nothing. He's looking straight in the arm. Yeah, oh, boy, I'm going to die. I don't know how to swim. You know how to swim? Yeah? You're going after him? Yeah? This is a hero. I don't know about things. This guy going after him, right? Okay? We all respect that, yeah? Right. Okay, but pardon me. The first thing that hits you, you know, this is New York. The East River is very polluted. Something that comes out of the bathroom. You know, nose to, you throw up, yeah? But you're in the dirt anyway, so you strengthen yourself. And they grab it, yeah? upon me, your hands are full of muck, you throw up another three times. You strengthen yourself, you grab it. This time he tries to kill you. You know, these guys are desperate. He takes his hands around your neck. Ah, you can't breathe. Yeah, he's going to choke you to death. Yeah? You know what to do? People, you got to know what to do. Yeah? You get it? Don't fight him. These guys are, he's like a maniac. Yeah? You can't, his strength is maniac. What you do is, you go down. You know? You go down. He thinks you're crazy. He climbs on top of your head. Yeah? He leaves go of you. Right? You come up behind him, you grab him, and now you're fighting the current. Now what's going on in his mind? It's the worst day of my life. I never should have come to New York. I'm going to shoot a circle line. This guy should have dropped dead before he ever laid eyes on me. Why me? Why me? I want to die. Why? Ah! He's miserable, right? He gets out, takes 50 hot showers, 20 hot baths, yeah? Until he can smell himself, yeah? Right? Then, gets a new suit of clothes, he gets a helicopter out to Boston. You're from Boston? All right, wherever you are. You're out of the city. I'm never going to visit New York the rest of my life. Does that read true? Yeah? Right? You agree that? Yeah? Okay, 20 years from now, we ask him, what was the greatest day of your life? Huh? What do you think he's going to answer? Come on, answer.
His bar mitzvah.
What is he going to answer? The day that I saved my brother's life. Yeah? But I want you to focus. You know what he's going to say? And you know what? I threw up 4 times. Did you ever throw up in your life? Tell us about it. Huh? Yeah. He's all excited. He threw up 4 times. What are you excited about? What's he excited about? I was a good man. I stuck in it. And you know what? He tried to kill me. So what are you excited about? I saved him. You want me to? Do you get it? Being good is memorable. It's powerful. Yeah? Did you see that? Okay, you're trying to be good. The rest of your life, people are going to take advantage of you because you want to be good. Yeah? Did that ever happen to you until now? Yeah, right? Did anybody ever get advantage of you because you want to be good? No? Now, did you ever loan somebody money and you feel that it's a little iffy, but you want to be a good guy? Come on. Yeah, you can't
afford it. I've heard that song, I'll pay you back.
Huh?
I've heard someone not pay me back.
Yeah, beat him up. All right, but he tried not to pay you back, huh?
Well, they tried.
All right, you guys get the picture. That's third-class pleasure, to be good. But it's a heck of a lot more than everything else. We'll die for it. Okay, second-class pleasure, he said, is to create. Second-class pleasure is power. People will kill for power. You got it? Will kill millions of their own countrymen to get power. Yeah? You know that? Power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. Yeah? What is it? What is it that they think they're getting? They think that if I can kill, I can create a third life. 1,000-year reign. So they come in turn. They're going to change the whole world. It's down. Yeah? Yeah? They think if I can kill, if I can control, I'll create a world. Yeah? You got it? Yeah. They're making a mistake. That's the counterfeit. That's the counterfeit. Even a monkey can destroy a work of art. Can't create a Rembrandt. To create, what do you need? Wisdom. So in Judaism we say that if you understand what life is about, you're creating a human being instead of a donkey. To be a strong donkey, powerful donkey, a successful donkey, is still a donkey. Unless you know what it's about. You got it? Wisdom. That is a pleasure. Now you're going to search for it all your life. Star Wars. I think they're going to teach you, huh? You're going to be a Jedi Knight. And the Force be with you. You're going to read a book that's going to teach you. You're going to read commentaries to tell you whether we should be in Iraq or not. When did you think about it yourself? Yeah? You think whether the radical Islam is coming to get us? Yeah? What do you say? Did you think it through? Did you look, sift through the evidence? What should we do if radical Islam is coming to get us? If there's 5,000 sleepers in the United States and they got atomic weapons, yeah? What should we do? What should we do? Never mind. Sleep on, sweet Hamlet. Yeah? Yeah, it bothers you. You know that you've got to make decisions. Okay, first class pleasure. First class pleasure is otherworldly pleasure. It's being in touch with the ultimate reality, the ultimate desire that we have, and that is the ascetic experience. You ever had that one? Yeah? You know what it is? Yeah? You know what it is? Under the sky at night. Or, what is man? After rain, beauty, forest, a hurricane, or otherworldly power, otherworldly beauty, we've touched God. That's the other God. Okay, so in Judaism we say, know what you're living for. So every morning and every night, yeah? And we have it on the mezuzah, and we put it on the tefillin. We say, Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. The next line is, V'ahavta es Hashem Elokecha. Chol levavcha, both desires. Chol nafshecha, your life, chol miyudecha. Those are the five. Repeat in the morning, repeat it at night. Remember, that's what you're living for. What do you think your mezuzah was for? Ward off evil spirits? Open it up and read it. If you read it intelligently, you see the okay, any questions? Come on, I'll take a couple of questions. You guys make a decision. Is this what it's about or not? Is this, are we here for pleasure? You want something else?
So, you sound like you trade up your family and your wife and your kids for third class pleasure. Would you trade it for second and first?
Yeah, of course. The thing is that it's ridiculous. You can't get it. You see, third class pleasure, you know you can get. Second, you can't do it by trading them. Yeah?
Right.
But we'll give up for power. We'll give up. People kill their children for
right.
Power.
But there are plenty of people who value their family and their and the life that they have more than, you know.
It's good to give up your own. Except when you got to kill someone. Then you give it up. But what do you mean to understand? When do you have to kill your wife and children to understand? Or to love God, what do you mean you got to? You can't, there's no time that it will be a conflict. You understand? Any other questions?
Would you repeat like this?
Fifth class pleasure is physical material pleasure. What might you want? It's the music. It's the whole world.
The whole world.
It's fifth class. It's good. For every Jewish kid. For every human being. Let the songs roll. Yeah? Nothing compared to love. For your children and you have all of this.
Can you say the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Yes.
That's what we're saying. Fifth class. Oh, you want to go the other way? Love.
No, that's fine.
Fifth class pleasure is physical material pleasure that money could buy. Fourth class pleasure is love. And the easiest love is to love your children. The greatest love should be, you guys don't even understand it, your wife and your husband. Get it? Unless you spend a year in the yeshiva. You're not going to make it, yeah? Children, we have a natural, we'll love them no matter what. You know, a wife, She insults you. Children insult us all the time. What can you do? Yeah? You get it? Fourth class pleasure is love. Third class pleasure is meaning. It's to do right. It's good. And the counterfeit is success. You're going to sweat to be successful. You build a business. You get a job as an accountant. Whatever you do. You go into a competition. And whatever you do, you're going to sweat, yeah, to be successful. And if you're not successful, you're going to wither. You're going to wither. You need to be good. Second class pleasure is to create power, to create, to change the world. We all want to make a difference. We all want to change the world. You give up. Don't give up. You can change the world. First class pleasure is the ultimate, is the meaning of it all, is the otherworldly pleasure of loving God.